Hello and welcome to our discussion of the case study, CDK Digital Marketing, Addressing Channel Conflict with Data Analytics. CDK Digital signed a 5-year contract with General Motors to be the exclusive website vendor to its US network of more than 4,000 dealers. 4 years had passed and now CDK Digital faced a crucial contract renewal at the end of 2012. In July 2011, two key personalities at CDK Digital, first, the Melissa McCain, Director of Strategic Marketing, and number two, Chris Reed, CMO, Chief Marketing Officer, had to give a presentation to the Customer Relationship Management Subcommittee of the Chevrolet Dealer Council of General Motors. GM dealers, like all auto dealers in the United States, were independent franchisees. However, General Motors considered the renewal of CDK Digital's exclusive contract as a collaborative decision between dealers and General Motors. As such, if the dealer council said no, the contract would not be renewed. Following are the learning objectives of this case study. Number one, demonstrate how big data and analytics can be used to solve channel conflict. Number two, explain how franchisors and franchisees have different perspectives on the value of data on retail operations. Number three, recognize benefits of big data and analytics that reach well beyond the obvious potential improvements to marketing and operational effectiveness. Number four, articulate the value of data analytics for channel management. And number five, appraise the benefits of real-time website customization. Following are the assignment questions of this case study that you should be able to solve after a detailed case analysis during this presentation. Question number one, what misalignments cause channel conflict between manufacturers and dealers in the automotive industry? How was this conflict reflected in the attitudes of General Motors and its dealers toward the CDK Digital program? Question number two, how would you characterize CDK Digital's core competencies as of 2011? Question number three, suppose a car shopper's interest could be known when she visited a dealer website. How would the dealer want to treat her? What about the OEM? Question number four, how can CDK Digital leverage its core competencies to provide a website solution that both General Motors and its dealers consider to serve their individual interests? Now let's begin our analysis of this case study. This case is set during a crucial contract renewal with General Motors. The objective of this case study is to provide students an opportunity to discover that analytics can mitigate channel conflict. In fact, if we look at the case study and this objective that we just mentioned, then the idea behind the analytics is quite simple. If analytics can provide a metric that unambiguously suggests that either manufacturer or dealer interest should dominate or prevail, then both parties are much more likely to consent to follow the prescription provided by this metric. As an example, consider the following question. Which vehicle should be featured on a dealer's website? Hero Shot. Hero Shot refers to the main picture that would be displayed at the top of the dealer's website. So the question here is that which vehicle should be featured on the top of the dealer's website? Let's consider an example. Let's assume that a consumer who reached a dealer's website after typing Chevy Cruze into Google, and then this particular customer clicked on a Chevy Cruze $2,000 customer's cash ad that was placed by Chevrolet. And then the customer used the dealer's locator function on the Chevy website. Then this particular customer would be more likely interested to buy a Chevy Cruze. And that is very obvious. In contrast, if a consumer who had not previously searched for any particular vehicle and this customer used Google to search for Chevy dealer, for example, in Angleton, Texas. Angleton, Texas is basically a city in the Texas state of United States. And then this customer clicked on CDK Digital dealer website. That consumer probably would want the local average vehicle preference, for example, a pickup truck. CDK Digital's solution to the channel conflict problem was to use its ability to track consumers' online behavior to distinguish between these two ways of reaching a dealer's website. By building a model of intent for each shopper that reached a dealer website, enabled CDK Digital to get General Motors and its dealers to agree on what content to show to that particular shopper. If you look at our previous example, the approach mentioned here would help both parties, that the manufacturers and the dealer, except that it would be appropriate to show the Chevy Cruze Hero Shot to the first shopper and a Chevy Silverado Hero Shot to the second shopper. The dealer council members saw that this approach would enable dealers to control what a consumer would see on the dealer website if that consumer was responding to advertising paid by the dealer, or what to show to the customer if the customer came through the brand messaging supported or sponsored by the dealer. However, if the shopper was driven to the dealer's website by OEM marketing efforts, dealers likewise understood that the optimal strategy to convert that particular shopper into a prospective sale was to deliver a consistent OEM brand experience, or we can say that the experience provided by the General Motors or the manufacturer. By focusing on what was right for the consumer and showing dealers they could control the experience if their efforts delivered the shopper to the dealer website, this approach removed much of the emotion from the discussion of who owned the customer and my website versus GM website. Furthermore, using data to design multiple consumer experiences on a single content platform enabled General Motors to perform network-wide analytics to optimize its overall sales performance. In summary, we can say that using analytics in the form of a model of intent provided by the CDK Digital actually did not change the fact that manufacturers and dealers had different objectives that were sometimes in conflict as well. However, the conflict was massively reduced when the discussion of how to treat consumers moved from general and abstract goals to specific and concrete goals. A dealer's quest for flexibility still stood in fundamental opposition to the manufacturer's quest for consistency. However, once a consumer's intent was clear, General Motors and its dealers had little trouble agreeing on the website customization that would best serve each shopper and lead to a sale that would benefit all parties. This shifted dealers' perception of CDK Digital from a vendor that helped enforce General Motors' interests to a vendor that helped dealers give shoppers what they wanted. McCain and Reed were concerned about General Motors' contract renewal decision for two particular reasons, and these were two most important reasons. The first reason was that the larger share of revenue that the General Motors contract represented for CDK Digital. The case states that General Motors accounted for the majority of CDK Digital's revenue. So if they lose the contract with the General Motors, that could be a serious blow to their bottom line. The second reason was dealer satisfaction with CDK Digital solutions. Dealers had the perception that perception was created by the CDK Digital competitors that CDK Digital was not doing a good job in SEO. If you recall our discussion from e-commerce, SEO refers to search engine optimization. The dealers also irritated at General Motors rules, and these rules were obviously enforced by CDK Digital in the website design of the dealer. And these rules restricted what dealers could do with their websites. In order to differentiate themselves from other dealers of the same brand in their local markets, dealers wanted their personal branding and messaging featured prominently, and this was not adequately reflected in the CDK Digital websites that were created for the dealers. Okay, now let's discuss some of the misalignments that actually caused the channel conflict between the manufacturers and dealers in the automotive industry. This case describes how CDK Digital used big data and analytics capabilities to solve one of the most fundamental problems in auto retailing. And this problem is that dealers and manufacturers frequently do not share the same objectives when marketing to potential customers. Now, this channel conflict arises from the fact that manufacturers sell their cars using many different independent dealers, and dealers often own franchises for different nameplates, either from the same manufacturers, for example, Chevrolet and Cadillac, or from competing manufacturers, for example, Chevrolet and Toyota. A manufacturer ultimately does not care which dealer a consumer buys from, as long as this consumer buys the manufacturer's car. On the other hand, the dealer does not necessarily care which nameplate a consumer purchases, as long as this particular customer buys from one of the dealer's franchises. In fact, dealers often find that the most cost-effective way to generate a lead is to attract a shopper from a competing dealer of the same franchise. Channel conflict also is rooted in the fact that dealers exclusively care about their local market conditions. On the other hand, manufacturers make marketing decisions either for the entire country or for large geographic regions. Consider one example. If General Motors determined there was too much system-wide inventory for its Chevy Cruze brand, Chevrolet marketing organization could promote a customer cash offer for Chevy Cruze across all its sites where potential buyers may come to buy a car. This would include the Chevrolet manufacturer website and all Chevrolet dealer websites. Chevrolet dealers in areas where compact cars play a minor role. Remember that Chevy Cruze is a compact car. So the Chevrolet dealers in areas where compact cars play a minor role may not be interested in showing the Chevy Cruze promotion on their website. For example, a dealer in a rural Texas area may argue that local customers are primarily pickup truck buyers. And if they promote the Chevy Cruze, then it would displace a much more relevant ad for a Chevy Silverado truck. Chevy Silverado truck is basically a pickup truck. So the question is that why this is a problem for CDK Digital. CDK Digital's original value proposition for General Motors and its dealers was that the single platform approach would give General Motors more control of dealer websites. CDK Digital solution clearly delivered this promise. However, dealers considered CDK Digital solution inflexible because dealers were unable to fully customize their websites to their own interests. In addition, dealers did not like that CDK Digital solution allowed General Motors to monitor what happened on their websites. They viewed such capability of CDK Digital solution as a tool used by General Motors to control the dealers. This presented a significant challenge for CDK Digital because it was caught squarely in the channel conflict between General Motors and its dealers. Aligning itself solely with the General Motors interest would be very dangerous for CDK Digital. Why? Because the dealers were very powerful. And if the dealers feel that CDK Digital is actually partial and focusing more to fulfill the objectives of GM and not the objectives of the dealers, they may decide not to go with the CDK Digital solution. As the chief marketing officer Reed quoted in the case, GM hired CDK Digital, but its dealers can fire us. Okay, in this part of the presentation, we would discuss the CDK Digital's core competencies as of 2011. CDK Digital was formed in 1995 and focused on connecting dealers with both shoppers and manufacturers. The company won endorsements from many known brands in automotive industry, such as Lexus, Mitsubishi, Acura, Nissan, and Volkswagen. In 2007, General Motors awarded CDK a 5-year single platform contract to provide websites to its national network of dealers. Over the time, CDK Digital developed sophisticated capabilities in online advertising. CDK Digital's key advantage for online advertising was its ability to track a significant part of a car shopper's online journey using digital tags. These tags were also called cookies across all CDK Digital dealer websites. All OEM websites provided by CDK Digital and third-party websites that allowed CDK Digital to add its digital tags. So we can see that CDK Digital was able to track a car shopper from multiple avenues. This allowed CDK to track, for example, car brands and models researched, dealer websites visited, the ads clicked by the customers, and models viewed on affiliated third-party automotive information sites. In fact, CDK Digital could even track which car a consumer had looked at in a dealer's inventory. To put this information to use, CDK Digital acquired a company called AdMission in 2008. AdMission had developed technology that could dynamically, that is in real time, show ads to each shopper based on his or her unique online car buying journey. For example, if a consumer browsed a Chevy Cruze on Chevrolet.com, the consumer would see a Chevy Cruze ad during the next visit to a site where CDK Digital placed its ads. By combining data about car shoppers' online journey with local dealer content and inventory, CDK Digital could ensure that ads not only reflected consumer interest, but also current dealer needs. CDK Digital's capability to target ads enabled it to create a new line of business, that is, placing OEM and dealer advertising on participating automotive sites. CDK Digital also began coordinating OEM and dealer bidding on search engine keywords. This coordination ensured that manufacturers and dealers did not increase the cost of the Google keywords by bidding against each other for the same keywords. Overall, CDK Digital built a sophisticated advertising platform that used analytics to customize content to individual consumers in real time based on their specific online car buying journey. CDK Digital had developed true big data capabilities handling user interactions with over 20 million website visits and 1 billion ad impressions per month across hundreds of thousands of unique creative executions. No other company in the automotive industry had this capability. In this section of our presentation, we would discuss how a dealer would treat a particular car shoppers if the car shopper's interest could be known when this shopper visited a dealer's website. Now, knowing what a consumer is interested in does not eliminate the fact that manufacturers and dealers have different objectives that may conflict. However, the conflict can be massively reduced if we move this conflict from abstract to the concrete. A dealer's quest for flexibility may stand in fundamental conflict with the manufacturer's quest for consistency. However, for the specific question of what hero shot to show a shopper who is clearly interested in a Chevy Cruze, the dealer and manufacturer can easily agree on a decision. Similarly, when a consumer is attracted by the local ad of a dealer and has no prior history of shopping for a specific car model, a manufacturer will likely have no problem agreeing to allow the dealer show what is most appropriate for the local market. Consider an example. Suppose a consumer reached a dealer's website after typing Chevy Cruze into Google and by clicking on Chevy Cruze $2,000 customer cash ad placed by Chevrolet. And then this customer used the dealer location function on Chevy website. Here we understand that OEM and dealers don't really disagree on what content to present to individual consumers, conditional on knowing what these consumers are interested in. We also understand that much of the channel conflict comes from disagreement between OEMs and dealers about what consumers are interested in. For example, a dealer may say that they are on the website because they want to buy a pickup truck, or the General Motors can say they are on your website because they want to buy a Chevy Cruze. So having a shared understanding of consumer intent is the key to solve this channel conflict. CDK Digital's experience in real-time customization of ads was based on analytics that determined consumer intent. In this section of our presentation, we would discuss that how CDK Digital could leverage its competencies to provide a solution that is acceptable for both General Motors and its dealers. The solution for McCain and Reed to this problem is to adapt the CDK Digital model of intent used for advertising and apply it to customizing each dealer website in real time. To make the solution realistic, McCain's team storyboarded a number of different online shopper journeys and mocked up how CDK Digital would be customizing a dealer's website for each of these different shoppers. The meeting of the CRM subcommittee of the Chevrolet Dealer Council on July 18, 2011 went extremely well. In the following months, CDK Digital showed this solution to other GM dealer councils and gained the support of GM dealers. The effort succeeded, and CDK Digital was able to win the contract renewal. Ultimately, if we look at what the CDK Digital provided as a solution to address the channel conflict, then basically CDK Digital provided two solutions. First, the CDK Digital changed its website solution, and they referred to this new website solution as Flex Platform. In this Flex Platform, what they did, they widgetized the website. Now, by widgetizing the website, we mean that we split the website into individual self-contained widgets. A widget is a component, a standalone component, a self-contained component placed on the website. And by using these widgets, they provided dealers an easy-to-use website customization option. Now, the dealers were able to rearrange different standards element where they wanted them on their individual website. And of course, these widgets were approved by General Motors. So, for example, one dealer could place the inventory listing on the top left, while another dealer could place the inventory listing on the bottom right. But note that inventory listing was there. Now you had the option where you want to place it. This gave dealers more of the flexibility they wanted to differentiate themselves from the competing dealers. The second solution was that each widget was responsive to a shopper's online journey. CDK Digital used analytics to determine shoppers' intent, and once this is determined where appropriate, it determined what the widget would be showed to each consumer. For example, if a consumer who had clicked on Chevy Silverado ads on Google would see Silverado at the top of the inventory widget, when this particular consumer visited the dealer website.